Let's move on and talk about politics, because the president's got to keep his eye on about four or five plates today as spinning in the air. And this week, last week, you sat on the couch and you said you feared, and I'll just paraphrase, you feared that all the mean things that people had said about the president were true if he told these DACA kids to leave. He did, said he said gave him a six-month, gave Congress six-month window to come up with a deal for the 800,000 that were brought here by their parents at a very young age. And the president took it a step farther yesterday, tweeting this out. For all those DACA kids that are concerned about your status during the six-month period, you have nothing to worry about. What's your reaction?
My reaction is that I like to think in my own mind, that in my own heart, that my dear old friend, the 45th president of the United States, who was watching Fox and Friends that morning, heard my heartfelt plea and knew that if people like me, who are rooting for him 100%, tell him that this is a very bad thing to do and that I have to rethink my relationship if he went down that road to be heartless and cruel, as some of his critics were suggesting that I couldn't be friends with him anymore. Well, whatever it was, I don't know if I had a scintilla of influence, but I am delighted that the president of the United States has done the right thing for these 800,000 absolutely comprehensively vetted young people, all of whom have jobs or in the military or in college. I think that he did a wonderful, wonderful thing. He is right. Congress has to pass a law. Congress legislates, not the presidency. But he had enough pragmatic idealism, is what I call it. He had enough compassion, but also the good sense of a businessman to say, listen, you kids, you haven't done anything wrong. Your parents dragged you here when you were babies, or, you know, the average age 6 years old, and I'm not going to punish you for the deeds of your parents or the deeds of the former president of the United States, who went arguably beyond his constitutional authority to pass this executive order.